He was recruited for Pegasus as his father, Raymond F. Basiago, was a projects engineer in the Ralph M. Parsons Corporation, an electronics and engineering company hired to work for Pegasus in the Curtiss Wright Aeronautical Facility in New Jersey. For the trips between the ages of 7 to 12, Basiago Jr. would hold his father's hand, count to three, and jump through an energy curtain. Afterwards, they would find themselves in a dark tunnel moving forward. They called the tunnel the Jump Room, and when it closed, the men would reappear in a different location in the blink of an eye. The lawyer claims that he tested 8 different time travel technologies throughout Pegasus, but most instances involved some type of teleporter based on technical papers and designs supposedly found in Nikola Tesla's old apartment after he passed away in 1943. As stated by Basiago, the teleporting machine consisted of, quote, 2 gray elliptical booms about 8 feet tall, separated by about 10 feet, between which a shimmering curtain of what Tesla called radiant energy, a form of energy that Tesla discovered that is latent and pervasive in the universe, and has among its properties the capacity to bend time-space. As one of DARPA's time-traveling children, Andrew allegedly traveled to Ford's Theater in Washington, D.C. in April of 1865, just in time for President Abraham Lincoln's assassination. He claims to have done it not once, but 5 times. Basiago's alleged proof of time traveling is a photograph taken in Gettysburg, Pennsylvania in 1863 at the height of the Cold War. His trips were different each time, and Basiago claims that it was like, quote, they were sending us to slightly different alternate realities on adjacent timelines. As these visits began to accumulate, I twice ran into myself during 2 different visits. On another mission, the children allegedly traveled to the future, arriving in the year 2045, to receive small canisters with microfilmed summaries of DARPA intervening in events in the 70s, then returning them to the present. According to Basiago, the future was nothing like he imagined, in a good way. Quote, the environment was like a garden city of tomorrow, with a balance between the built and the natural environment, and very advanced activities were going on. I saw no automobiles and no pollution. There had clearly been a positive transformation of society that involved the use of teleportation to obviate all these other very polluting forms of transportation that we use today. Obama in outer space. As if Andrew Basiago's claims weren't outrageous enough, he also claims that one of his child co-workers was a teenage Barack Obama, who then went by the name Barry Satoru. According to the Chrononaut, they both traveled to secret American military bases on Mars, visiting the area twice between 1981 and 1983. The missions to outer space were to acclimate Martians to human presence on their own planet and secure a possible alliance, as well as to fulfill the CIA's wish to, quote, establish a defense regime protecting the Earth from threats from space. As part of the mission, the time-traveling teenagers had to be respectful of their surroundings and as quiet as possible. Army Major Ed Dames allegedly told Obama that, simply put, quote, your task is to be seen and not eaten. During one of the trips, Basiago and Satoru exchanged a few friendly words while en route to the jump room to travel to outer space. To acknowledge his fellow comrade, Barry merely told Basiago, quote, we're here. Basiago and Obama, now the 44th President of the United States, did not keep in touch after their travels to outer space. Not surprisingly, the White House has vehemently denied Obama's role as a Martian conquistador for the CIA, in the words of Tommy Viator, the spokesman for the National Security Council. However, in an unexpected turn of events, Chrononaut Andrew Basiago ran for president in 2016. According to Basiago, he was already sure he would be elected, as he once saw himself winning the election during one of Project Pegasus's trips to the future. In an official interview, Basiago stated that he knew he would win between 2016 and 2028 because he was sure he would not run past that. Basiago's campaign heavily relied on his past experiences with time travel. A statement on his campaign website claimed that, quote, for 70 years, the U.S. government has been concealing advanced technologies because they might be socially, economically, or technically disruptive in nature. These technologies include the teleportation technology developed by DARPA's Project Pegasus. They may also include cancer cures. The government should begin a program to declassify and deploy this knowledge. The standard of technical disclosure should be what provides the people the best available technology. This will enable the United States to reclaim its mantle as the world's catalyst of applied science. In addition to being an alleged time traveler, Basiago is also a fervent believer in the existence of the Sasquatch. Even before Project Pegasus, a toddling Andrew spotted the strange creature with a child on a trip to the Adirondacks. In another official interview, Basiago bragged that he was, quote, the first presidential candidate since Theodore Roosevelt to affirm the existence of Sasquatch based on a personal encounter. As a scratcher, Andrew Basiago promised that, if elected, he would name the Sasquatch as an American endangered species and would assign part of the national budget to preserve the creatures. Fact or fiction?
Dobro jutro, dan ili noć, vi se nalazite na kanalu Stigmatik. Fakt ili fikcija je najmanje bitno u svoj ovoj priči, jeli. Meni ovaj čovjek ne ostavlja neki veliki dojam. Ajmo reći da je dosta toga, možda je izmislio, možda plod njegove mašte i dječije. Ali ono što je bitno jeste da je DARPA radila te projekte i da projekt Pegasus je postojao. Znači da su se koristile tehnike Nikole Tesle, Leonardo da Vincija, Nostradamusa, ljudi koji su, Alberta Einsteina, mnogih naučnika kojima ne znamo imena jer se često ne pominju. Ali uglavnom, najviše se koristile tehnike Nikole Tesle i postoje neki naznake. Pogotovo u budućnosti, on 70. Nije mogao da, doduše on nije počeo pričati 70. Međutim, ove stvari koje se već sad dešavaju, znači putovno naseljavanje Marsa, Obamin izbor, da je to bio Obama, da li nije, nije toliko bitno, znači sam Basiago. Basiago je samo jedno od djece, volio bi čuti ostalu djecu, gdje su ona nestala? Jer je on toliko neuvjerljiv i njegova priča je sva onako razbacana da su oni njega pustili da priča. Moguće oni koji su bili uvjerljivi, koji su imali šta za reći, da su uklonjeni. Ko što je vjerovatno i Tesla 43. Dobro, jeste bio bolestan, jeste sve, ajmo reći da ne bi živio još dugo, ali prekraćen je, znači... Ali ono što je najzanimljivije jeste da su 70. radili te pokuse, hajmo reći, neke 10% uspješno bilo. Zamislite sada uz ovu tehnologiju, jer se tek nakon 70. događa ta tehnološka evolucija i revolucija. Tek, znači, se tih bajni 40 godina dešava iza 80. Zamislite šta sad rade. Jer ja znam, recimo, za kloniranje ljudi, pa se to klonirala se ovca, to se vjerovatno radi u tajnim laboratorijama. Još 98. sam znao za tu sektu klonoid, kad je u suštini čitav internet prije Facebooka bio dark deep web. Jer ste vi imali, znači, Gmail, Yahoo i forume, u suštini sve je bilo deep web. Samo niste imali, pojavile se te društvene mreže, tađe, ne znam, koje su bile više onako za kockanje, i za bavljenje treba, ono, ili treba muškaraca, znači za neko upoznavanje više. Ko što i Facebook sam bio u početku, pa i za slušanje muzike, to je YouTube, suštini najviše u radio, pa je tako uništio, pa se reći, pofinu muzičku industriju. Međutim, da ne skrećemo s teme, znači da je DARPA imala već tada takvu tehnologiju da se bavi time. Da li su... Oni su, znači, ulagali novac u to. Oni danas ulažu novac u VAR pogon. Pogledajte moja videa koja će biti, znači, dole u najavi. Ja vas, ja baš i ne vjerujem, znači, u pola stvari, ali vjerujem da bi volio čuti priču druge djece. Bilo ih je puno, znači, uđu kroz neki prostor i onda se nađu u nekoj godini. Da li vide ubistvo Lincolna, da li vide Max, šta li vide, da li vide... Zaista zvuči fascinantno, jer oni nikad nisu negirali projekt Pegasus. Jeste američka vlada, ali nije nikad CIA i DARPA. Čak se DARPA falila na svojim sajtovima projektom Pegasus. I čak su ga i pominjali nekoliko puta na svojim summitima koje ja gledam po sat vremena, ne mogu i pušiti na nečemu, bi dosadno. A imate na DARPinoj stranici na YouTube-u. Eto, toliko, znači, u ovom videu da vidite, znači, da se dan danas, znači, može svašta uraditi. kad zamislite da se 70-ih radilo to, znači putovalo kroz vrijeme i otprilike da se budućnost planira, arhitektizira, znači masonski izraz arhitekta budućnosti, jeli, to je DARPA. Znači, povezano jako nekako masonerija, DARPA, sve to. Ne želim da ispadam teoretičar zavjere, nego nudim znači, nešto što je potkovano sa činjenicama, to je da se koristila napredna tehnologija i skrivala od običnog svijeta. I danas se to isto radi, samo u puno, puno većoj mjeri. Čak, znači, sve ovo što imamo, znam ste tad mobitel da je neko vidio. 70-ih, da ste nekom pričali. Meni kad su 90-te pričali da će mobitel biti 0,9 mm, da već ima takav u Japanu, ja sam govorio luci, nakon 5 godina mi je takav bio u luci. Znači, sljedeće što dolaze su čipovi, cyber sigurnost, vjerovatno će ovi mobiteli koji sada, evo, Lejla drži, izaći iz mode, snimat ćemo se nekako drugčije. Evo, već sad ulazimo u metaverzu, mi to smo radili, znači Facebook će nosi 3D, Elon Musk kaže zašto nosi, ajmo u grad, znači u mozak. Idemo prebrzo po meni, a duhovno smo zakržljali, što dokazuju i ma duhovna videa, znači manje ljudi na tim videima nego što će biti recimo na ovom videu, jer ljudi vole jednostavno hype, vole znači nesigurnost, strah i tako. Eto, toliko, pozdravljam vas Lexi Stigmatika, vidimo se i čujemo uskoro, nadam se opet, da vas dalje ne uznemiravam, čao.